But guys, later on as we start the preparation, after some time in September, October comes, we are near to the exams. Very few months before, generally we generally feel that now we may not be able to do, we may not be able to reach our goal. Then when these kind of situation occurs, guys, at that time we got demotivated. So guys, at that time then we tried to think that leave that subject. So that's why today in this session I want to tell you that, as you know, if you are targeting a PSU, you want 75 plus marks. If you are targeting an IIT, you want 65 to 70 plus marks. So guys, for that, if you are already make a mind that you are going to leave any of the subject. So guys, for that subject, I will be telling you some those important topics, which if you are going to attempt only those small 20 to 30% topic, those topics can give you 70 plus marks. Means by leaving that subject, just by doing those topics which I will be giving you, just by doing that, you can score at least 70 to 80% from that subject also. So that is the target of this session. Many times, many of the students have requested that, sir, why, this session is okay, you are going to tell us, then how to prepare for these topics, how we shall go for those topics. So guys, I would like to tell you one thing, that for these topics, I am going to announce a crash course also today, and that crash course will be there on YouTube. For it is available for all of you guys, and whatever the topics I will be telling you today from all the top, all the subjects, those topics will be taught to you also on YouTube. So we are going to start this crash course from Tuesday. So this is an announcement session for that also. And at the same time, I will be telling you those important topics. If you have already prepared somewhere, you are preparing, then okay, you can go with that. Otherwise, if you want to learn those topics, then also you can join us here. Okay, guys. So yes, many of the students have already commented. So good evening, Jay, Pawan, Akshay Satyan. Good evening, Shivam, Pawan. Okay, thanks, dear. So, Laila Aditya, good evening. Prashant, good evening. Kalpesh, hello dear. Sharmila, good evening. Prashant, okay. Sir, I have only completed 50% of GATE ME. Should I want to concentrate on GATE ME or GATE XE to get into NITI Mumbai or IIT for higher studies? Guys, first of all, I already told you, if you are going for GATE XE paper, then it is not going to affect your mechanical preparation. It is not going to affect your mechanical preparation if you are going for GATE XE preparation, because XE is having those subjects only which mechanical is having. So preparing for XE will not affect your ME preparation, first of all. Okay, that is going to give an advantage only, no disadvantage. But I will say, when you are going to prepare, AXE is an extra thing that may make you reach into the NIT Mumbai IIT, that for sure. But guys, don't leave mechanical, because from AXE paper, either you will be getting IIT or NIT Mumbai, that's fine. But guys, if you will not be getting 100-200 AIR, then mechanical, if you are going to perform average also, you will be getting at least NIT, at least Government Engineering College. So guys, this session is for you, because in this session, I will be telling you, if you are reaching at 50, how to reach at 70. And that is not with too much of hard work. No, with very less few smart works. Okay. By the topics which are asked more, just concentrating on those topics, you can score 70 plus marks. Every year, I give these types of topics list to the students. And every year, students find that majority of the questions are coming from these topics only. This is based on analysis of previous years. Okay, guys. So it is going to be advantageous for you. Mohit Kundu, good evening. Malai, good evening. Okay, Mr. Anonymous, but it is not feasible for today, this session. Thanks, Ashok, for your wonderful words. So guys, please share this session to others also, so that others can also be benefited. So let us start, guys. Abhishek Sankla and Kostav, good evening to all of you. Okay guys, so today let us start, and I will be telling you the important topics, and we are going to start the crash course over YouTube only, with this time 8 PM to 9:30 PM or 8 PM to 9:15 PM, like 1 to 1.5 hour session, Monday to Friday daily will be there, where we will be discussing the important topics of each subject in mechanical engineering. We will continue this crash course up to the December 31st.
and we will be completing all important topics. So we are not only giving you the topics, we will be teaching you those topics also. So if you have any doubt in those, just attend me. Just by following us properly, you can score that much. Right now, you have to start. Okay? So let us see, guys. So we will be discussing. This is a certain some detail about me. So guys, this is AxiBat that I yesterday announced to you, faculty teams. That is, today is properly launched. Okay, so you can see the previous lectures as well as the study plan, which will be started from 22nd of this month. So you can also enroll into this batch. This batch will give you a proper guidance, proper preparation for AXI only, because here the syllabus, questions, test series, everything will be given in the form of how the AXI level is. Okay, so it is going to help you in mechanical also. Okay, so because the syllabus is same, only the level of question is slightly 5 to 10% high. That we always try to do for our paper also. Okay guys, so these are the features of the courses. This is the number from which you can ask any detail. And now I am starting this session, guys, and I am starting from the wonderful subject, theory of machines. You know, theory of machine is the wonderful, most interesting subject of the mechanical engineering. And why it is so? Because guys, this subject is very much close to the heart. Why? Because many of the configurations are related to Sir James Watt. You already know, known to be the godfather of mechanical engineering. So guys, Sir James Watt's majority of the configuration we study in this subject. So guys, I will be telling you some of the important topics in all the subjects to which, if you are referring, guys, your 70 plus marks will be confirmed. Like if you are talking about the simple mechanism topic, guys, you can see 80 to 90% of the times the questions are asked only from three things. What are those three things? First is degree of freedom. Second is crank and slotted lever mechanism. What is the third one? Third one is Grescher flow. So guys, these are the three topics from which 80 to 90% times questions are being asked, Grescher's law. So guys, I would like to tell you, these topics list, whatever I am giving, they are the important topics. Those who want 100 marks, go for complete syllabus. There is no if and but then. But if you want 70, 75 plus, but your preparations are according to 50 marks, guys, we are there to help you. We will try to make you reach up to your 70-75% mark, so that you can go for IITs or PSUs. For that, you need to join us regularly at 8 p.m. on this Grade Up Gate YouTube channel. We will be starting from strength of material from Tuesday. So guys, from simple mechanism, this is required. From velocity and acceleration diagram, when we are talking about, guys, here the most important thing from acceleration, I am starting from acceleration, it is basically Coriolis component. You can see 4 out of 5 questions are been asked from Coriolis component. Okay guys, Coriolis component of acceleration. The very most important thing from this topic is Coriolis component of acceleration. Then guys, we are having, in velocity there are two approaches. One is eye center, other is relative velocity. So guys, when we are talking about eye center and relative velocity approaches, so for relative velocity approach, the most important thing is the special cases which we study as when two input and output links are parallel to each other. These kind of cases we always refer. You can see previous year's questions are asking this kind of cases many number of times. From eye center, go for theorem of angular velocity, because questions are coming from that only. Theorem of angular velocity. So guys, these are some wonderful heart of the topics from where questions are being asked many times, means you can go for 80-90% times questions are coming from that. So guys, in relative velocity approach, you can add one more thing, that is the crank and slotted lever mechanism. Only once the question is been asked, but my intention says that you may get a question this year from that velocity analysis of crank and slotted lever mechanism. Okay guys, so yes guys, Malai, good evening. Mohit Kundu, good evening guys. Any other question also you can ask me. Yes, Abhishek Sakla, I will be sharing the PPT for app student. Definitely it will be shared. Those students who have not downloaded the Grade Up app, please download the Grade Up app. Follow me there. I will be sharing this PPT also with you, so that you can see, if you cannot write down each and everything, you can have this PPT with you. Okay guys, so next is gears and gear train. When I am talking about gear and gear train, Gear train, one question is confirmed. When we are talking about gear train, guys, yes, previously, if you see, majority of the questions are coming from epicyclic gear trains only. But guys, here I will not say you to restrict here, because in the last year, they started reverted gear trains also. For the first time in 2020 and 2019, they have asked the reverted gear train. Before that, no question over that. Compound gear train was asked for the first time in 2013. So guys, here we cannot take risk. And it is a very easy topic. From gear train, you can go for compound gear train. Reverted gear train is also a type of compound gear train. So compound, yes, compound, and then reverted, and then epicyclic. So go for all these three. It is very easy. Tabular method you need to see, as well as add one topic here, that is the line diagram. Because sometimes to make the question difficult, they make the line diagram of the gear. I generally teach this in the class. Nobody teaches this. So if you want to see how the line diagrams are plotted, you can join me on Grade Up YouTube channel. I will be teaching line diagrams. How you can see, means have you seen this kind of diagrams of gears? Then by looking into that kind of diagram, we do not understand which kind of gear it is, like this. They are making in this way. Okay, so I will be telling you what is the meaning of which kind of things. Okay, like arms are made like this, they make it like this. So these types of diagrams I will be teaching you, don't worry. Okay guys, so yes guys, please share this to others also, so that others can also be benefited. Yes, Anurag sir, what is the duration of course on YouTube? Dear, we will be having this course will go up to 31st of the December, and Monday to Friday the classes will be there. Okay, and if required, we may go for some long sessions also. Thanks, Viganesh. Okay, Laila Aditya. Yes, dear. Okay. So guys, don't worry. Those will be available on YouTube. You can attend whenever you want. Okay. Dear, I will be completing all the subjects today only. Today only I will be telling you all the topics from all the subjects. Sir, after completing topics, how to revise all those formula sheets and how to remember? Dear, never try to remember the formulas just by mugging up. Better than that, go for 3-2. As well as, I also discuss how to prepare notes. But this is not the time to make notes. This is the time to revise. So, by looking onto that session, you will be getting complete information about this. Okay guys, now let us move to the next part. Next is flywheel and governor. Guys, you know that flywheel introduction is coming from kinematic and dynamic analysis from single slider crank mechanism. So, from kinematic analysis, guys, from kinematic analysis, you need to remember the formula for velocity and acceleration. And from dynamic analysis, you need to remember the formula for torque. And if you remember that, this torque is coming from Ft. So it will be better if you remember the formula for tangential force and twisting moment. And then when you will be discussing the flywheel, energy equation is required. You know, 9 out of 11 questions have been asked in energy equation only. Is it okay, guys? So it is a very, very important thing in flywheels. And when it comes to governor, till date there is no question have been asked in gate. But guys, strong intuition, this time question will come. Because whatever the topics which are added in 2016, only one topic is left on which gate have not asked anything till now. So that is governor. So this year there are fair chance that you will get a question from that. Whenever questions are asked from governor, the very first time in any examination, they are asking from isochronous governor. So guys, I will say go for characteristics of governor. Because if you are going for characteristics and controlling force diagram, your questions will be covered in this controlling force diagram. So these two topics are major important topics. Also remember the formula for effort and power of governor. Okay, so individual analysis will not come from governor. Then when it comes to gyroscope, there is only one formula, I omega omega p. Whatever be the case, the way to see direction is also same. Here you need to remember, if you want to go for a special case, power plant shaft is the most important case. But guys, if you know the way to see the direction in gyroscope, whatever be the device, the question remains the same. Only the names will be changing. Okay, so power plant shaft is the most important thing here. And guys, then we are coming to balancing. For gate, only rotating and reciprocating parts balancing is important. Here, that different parts like engine balancing, what we study in general in classes, that never came till now in gate. So you can leave that if you want, because I am telling you important topics. If you are going for 100%, then study each and everything whatever I discuss in the class. But these are those topics which can make you, which can give you 70 to 75 plus marks. Okay, that is required for PSU and IIT. So guys, in balancing, otherwise you can go for rotating masses and reciprocating masses. That is a very, very, very small part. Rotating and reciprocating parts. Reciprocating balancing means you can leave the engine balancing. That is the part which is conventional, important for conventional, not for gate more. Okay. So you can go with that. I am looking at other doubts if any. Dev Patel. Srayas, okay, thanks dear. Mr. Anonymous, they will be available soon, don't worry about that. Thanks Anurag. Yes dear Rahul, but that is the situation for all the students, so don't worry about that, okay. Pawan is saying, sir, I am scoring less marks in mock test as compared to previous year's gate question paper, and they find question easy in gate previous years as compared to mock test. Dear, definitely whenever tests are made, in tests, we generally try to put questions harder than the gate level, because whenever we are going to prepare for an examination, we need to prepare certain higher level, up to certain higher level always, okay. So that is the requirement. So that is a good thing. So if you are getting less marks also in gate paper, you will be getting 10 to 15 plus marks. So don't worry about that. Okay guys, so don't worry about that. Okay, let us move further. So guys, next is vibrations. That is very, very important part guys. Complete tom at one side, complete vibration at one side. I already told you in the classes also. Guys, vibration itself is a very important part. So, if 6 marks theory of machines, whatever we have seen till now, 6 marks vibrations are confirmed. Theory of machines weightage may reduce, vibration weightage never reduces. Guys, when we see natural vibration, the most important methods here are torque method. One is torque method. And guys, the second method is relay method. So, these two methods are there which you shall never leave. These are the methods from 80 to 90% time questions are asked from these two methods only. Okay. And you know when to apply which method. Relay method is static deflection of mass method. When we see the damped vibration. Guys, in damped vibration only we are having certain formulas. Just remember that only very simple questions are asked from those 5 formulas only. Like one formula, you know that it is zeta C by CC. And you know that CC is nothing but 2 root SM. From this formula, 5 to 7 questions have been asked. Similarly, a formula for logarithmic decremental ratio. Similarly, a formula of damped frequency, which is 1 minus zeta square omega n. Okay, guys. So, these types of 5 formula, what you study for zeta, like for CC, I have written CC is 2 root SM. And there is one more formula that you know, that is for decremental ratio. So, guys, these are the 5 formulas from which the questions are coming. Similarly, in force damped vibration, you need to go for magnification factor. You need to go for transmissibility ratio. You need to go for critical speed of shaft. Okay, guys. So, these are the topics you need to study. So, from these 3 topics only, you will be getting the questions. So, that's why I was saying that in vibrations, it is very easy to score 4 marks from these 2 chapters. For these 2 marks, you need to work hard over these 2 methods, because whenever you are going to discuss, you see the method, whenever you see any question in natural vibration, you need to select the appropriate method. That is something for which you need to work hard. If you are choosing wrong method, you may lose marks, because then the question may go long and you may leave the question in between. That is the major issue. Okay. Dear, grade up. At grade up, XE course will start from 22nd. Study plan will start from 22nd. Dear, we will be taking engineering mechanics session also. Don't worry. Okay. I will be taking that as per your request.
definitely I will be taking. Okay. Okay, guys. If any other doubt, you can also ask and you can share this session with your friends so that other can also be benefited. In CAM and Fallover, guys, questions are nowadays asked from this topic also. Here you can go for four types of motion. Four types of motion. You know that out of these four types of motion, one is uniform velocity, uniform accelerated, simple harmonic motion, cycloidal motion. These four motions, you must know the expression for velocity, acceleration or jerk. Either you remember or you learn how to find out them. I told you in the classes how to find out them. So you can use that technique because for 2 marks question, you are already having 2.5 minutes in paper. In 2.5 minutes, they can easily be derived also. Okay, and if you have seen the graph, question may come from graph also. So from CAM and Fallover, this is the important topic. Theory of machines analysis is over, guys. Now let us move to the next subject. So next subject will be our strength of material. So guys, theory of machines weightage is around 12 marks plus vibration including. So when we are talking about around, you can say 6 to 8 marks is the weightage of this subject. This subject is a very vast, very big syllabus. But guys, it is a very important one. Okay. So without this, MD is not feasible. Dear TR is transmissibility ratio. Okay, Nicholas, definitely. Okay, guys. So any other question you can also ask. Now I am coming to simple stresses and strains. So guys, here the questions will be asked from stress-strain diagram. Stress-strain diagram. I will be starting the discussion from this only on Tuesday. And guys, when I will be teaching you this diagram, you will be learning many new things which you have not seen anywhere else. And I will be showing you the questions also asked on them. So if you have not studied that, how you can solve the questions. So please join us. In this crash course, you will be learning a lot more from whatever you have learned anywhere, wherever you are studying. Okay. Next, guys, on this is bars in series and parallel. Bars in series and parallel. So, bars in series and parallel. Guys, many times this is the easiest topic, you know, I know. But guys, still the questions are asked from this topic. So, every alternate year, they are asking from series or parallel bars one question. Okay, so it is definitely an important part if you see. So obviously you must go through it very nicely. Next question may be asked from elastic constant relations. So elastic constant relations, as I discussed also for different types of material, how many elastic constants are there? You have to remember independent elastic constants also for different materials like orthotropic, like anisotropic, like homogeneous and isotropic, and their relations, which elastic constant is bigger, which is smaller, all this discussion we will be having in classes. Pure bending, my dear, when we are talking about, there are only two things. One is the bending equation. M by I is equals to sigma B by Y is equals to E by R. Now you need to remember which case you need to use when. So guys, if radius of curvature is given, then you will be using sigma B by Y is equals to E by R. This kind of question in mechanical are more prominent, but in civil engineering questions are more asked from this equation, this part of the equation. But in mechanical engineering, they are asked more from this, because belt drive is an example used in mechanical engineering. There this equation is used. When you are going to say some wire is bent around this radius, again this question, this equation will be used. Second part from where the questions are asked is the beam of uniform strength. Beam of uniform strength. So guys, beam of uniform strength. Okay guys, and out of these two, if you want to leave something, this one is the most important part. This you shall not leave. At least you shall go with this equation. Your task will be over. Then when we are talking about the pure torsion, guys, here the questions are coming from the series and parallel connection majorly. Series and parallel connection. Series and parallel connection. So majorly questions are coming from series and parallel connection. So that is the important task. Okay. And when we are talking about second type of question, that is from comparison of shaft. Like if I ask you, there is a solid shaft, there is a hollow shaft, which shaft is better? So you have studied in the classes that solid shaft is better
if outer diameter is same, radial space is a constraint, hollow shafts are better if weight is a constraint. So that you have already seen in the classes. If you have not seen, join our crash course. We will be teaching you. I will be teaching you that. Okay. So these are the things, guys, from these topics. These are the important topics from where you will find majority of the questions. Guys, then next is principal stresses and strains. Guys, this chapter, basically, I will be saying that if you do not remember those analysis, no need for that. Just go for the formulas for principal stresses and tau max. And I would like to tell you here the question is coming only one. 9 questions out of 12 which they have asked in mechanical paper. They are what is the radius of Mohr circle. And radius of Mohr circle, you need not to go for Mohr circle. Radius of Mohr circle is simply tau max. That's why I say just remember these formulas. So if you know what is radius of Mohr circle, guys, this is the 9 out of 12 questions they have asked. What is the radius of Mohr circle? Second questions may come from the strain gauge row sets. Strain gauge row sets. Okay. So if you are going with these 2 to 3 things here, 2 marks will be confirmed. Okay. Questions will be coming from this topic only. When we are talking about theories of failure, that I will be covering in machine design, because in mechanical syllabus it is in MD. For civil syllabus it is in SOM. Let me see if there are any doubts are coming. Yes. Konda Avinash, solid mechanics of axis syllabus, sir. Yes, I will be taking solid mechanics syllabus, dear. Anurag, sir, will you discuss the numericals regarding the topics or only theory? Dear, I will be discussing both theory and numerical. Mr. Anonymous, sir, what are the subjects you are going to take in crash course? Dear, synth of material, theory of machines, these two parts I will be taking for sure. Malai, but we will be completing all the course by different faculties, because GradeUp is having a very big faculty team. So, Malai, is SOM total how many hours take complete syllabus? Dear, complete syllabus don't ask. Here we will not be covering complete syllabus. Complete syllabus, when I was teaching you, I taught you in 80 plus hours. Okay, in online mode, otherwise in offline I take 490-95 plus hours. But when we are talking about crash course, here that much hours are not required. That's why I said, by giving 20%, you are getting 70%. That's why I said. This is not the time our crash course, we can complete the one subject. Please mention how many days to spend maximum in each subject. Dear, if you are talking about this, I will be saying that depends on your preparation of different subjects. Guys, first of all, you must have a target what marks you want to get. Weightage wise, you need to go for. Like heat transfer, if you say only 4 topics are there. If you say conduction, convection, radiation, heat exchanger. If you have once studied, then not much time is required. If you want to go for crash course, 4 days will be enough. Yes, but if you are going for complete course, definitely the course will be bigger. Rectangular is enough. Okay, nice guys. So just guys, like this session and also share with your friends. Nitin, crash course will start on Tuesday. So how to increase the speed and accuracy? Dear, to increase the speed of and accuracy, you need to work for more test series. Now I am coming to thin pressure vessels. Guys, when we come to thin pressure vessels, I would like to tell you, questions are coming from thin cylinders majorly, not from thin spheres. And in thin cylinders, you just need to remember the formula for hoop stress and longitudinal stress. Okay, 99% time questions are coming from these two only. And you know, hoop stress is principal stress sigma 1, longitudinal is sigma 2. So to find out tau max is still easy, it is sigma 1 minus sigma 2 by 2. So only if you remember the formulas for principal stress and strain, thin cylinder task will be over. Okay guys, so these are four important topics. I am not saying 100%, I am saying 99%. Because 1% scope is always there for other topics. So if you are going for crash course, we are thinking of 70-75. If you are following for all the subject, my approach, 70-75 will be easy. Why I am saying 70-75? Because we are not covering complete syllabus. If you cover 100% syllabus at GradeUp, how we have taught to you in the subject, then you will be getting all the questions from those only. So we are covering less part. That's why I am saying 70 plus only. Okay. Let us see the next topic, guys. Next topic is SFD-BMD. Guys, in SFD-BMD, generally questions are coming from, first thing is support reaction calculation. Support reaction calculation. Now this is a topic which if you are going to cover, you need to cover it completely. But if your hands are very weak in this, means you are thinking to leave that topic. I will not suggest that to leave, because when we teach it, we teach it in a very wonderful way. Means you need not to remember even SFD-BMD equation. You need not to learn even how to make the equation. Whenever I teach this topic, you if you remember that. Guys, I just told you at that time, by looking at the loading diagram, we can make SFD. By looking at SFD, we can make BMD. There is no need of a single calculation. I told you at that time. And if possible, I will be teaching you on YouTube by taking some marathon session that topic. Okay? But guys, if you are very weak in this topic, then you can go for only two topics. One is support reaction, other is compound beam. But I will not say that here 90% time. Here 60 to 70% time questions are from these two topics only. Okay? But for these two, you need not to cover the complete chapter SFD-BMD. If you are taking it completely, then nobody can take your 2 marks from that if the question will come. In mechanical, question will come either of these two topics. In civil, questions will come for both the topics. In deflection, when we are talking about, guys, you go with principle of superposition. Principle of superposition is asked in a great detail. Principle of superposition, along with that, if you want to do, go for moment area method. Why I am saying this? Principle of superposition is for special cases. And I will say, guys, 80% time the question will be from this. Moment area method is for non-prismatic beams. For non-prismatic beams. And that will come for 10% of the time. And then strain energy method for rest 10%. Strain energy method rest 10% is for the connected beams, like this kind of structure if there. So that's why if you are only going with that, 80% possibility is still there. In column, you need to go only for the four boundary conditions and formula. Nothing more is required. It is hardly a 5 to 10 minutes job. Not more than that time is required. Questions will be coming once in 3 years. So definitely not a very important topic. Okay, guys, any other questions I need to see? Sir, to get PhD admissions in IIT and NIT, how much minimum score I need? Please tell me. I targeted to qualify just 31. So is it enough? Dear, to get in PhD, I would like to say that IITs have their different examination. Even today's NITs are also taking their different separate written exam. So GATE qualification will help you for sure. But guys, if you are going for directly PhD, you need to score or qualify a written examination for various IITs and NITs. Okay. But for M.Tech, if you want to go for NIT, IIT, guys, more than 60 will be a safe score for good branch in NIT. More than 70 will be a safe score for IIT. For PhD, only GATE qualification is required. For that, marks are not important. Okay. Sir, okay, PPT I will be sharing, Prince. Don't worry. Okay, Nitin, we will be taking a marathon of deflection and SFD-BMD. Yes, Varun, MV, Maths and FT will be covered in XC batch. Maths and FT will be covered in XC batch. Okay. Shreyas, don't worry. Don't worry. You just need to work hard under proper guidance. Okay. So, I will be sharing my email ID. You can contact me there if you have any kind of problem. You can directly contact me. I will be helping you personally if possible. In your preparation, I will give you a proper guidance which is required. Okay. Let us move further, guys. So next, miscellaneous will include strain energy and impact loading. In strain energy and impact loading, you need to remember a formula of impact factor. That you know that formula is. That formula will show you on which thing the impact stresses are depending. That is also very important, guys. So you need to go for that impact factor in miscellaneous. Okay. Second, I would like to tell you in thermal, guys. In thermal, there is a question which is deflection plus thermal, which is very important these days for mechanical. It will be coming. Deflection plus thermal question. That is a question from civil engineering. I always try to do that in the class. Here also I will be solving that, where they will be giving you a beam which is simply supported. and they will be giving you a temperature gradient from top to bottom fiber. So, and they will be asking you the deflection of the beam under this thermal. So these days they are asking thermal including with cylinders and beams. You can see the previous years. So here cylinder plus beam can also be asked. That also I covered in the course if you remember. So guys, these are very important topics for this year. And third thing, if you want guys, free expansion, both hand fix. These are two important cases for the thermal. Guys, from childhood we are having a habit to ask to our teachers, please tell us the important topics. Here I am telling you important topics. So just if you are going with these topics, you will be scoring very good marks. That is my promise to you. But follow these topics for those subjects which you are planning to leave properly. If you want to go for 100%, then give more emphasis to these topics. Okay. So in both the way it is going to help you. Next guys, SOM is over. Now we are coming to engineering mechanics. Okay guys, so now we are coming to engineering mechanics. So I feel today we will be able to discuss majority of the subjects but not complete. Some doubts are also coming. Abhishek, XC course will on YouTube. Dear, XC course is on grade up. Okay, you can just download the app and there you can see. Vidya Sagar, I have completed my syllabus but not able to score marks in test series. Dear, for that proper revision and practice is required. Obviously dear, that will be fine if you are going to complete the syllabus. That's fine. Very nice strategy. Is it definitely enough? Okay, it is definitely enough. Okay guys, for engineering mechanics, when we are talking about trusses, method of joint is okay. No need to go for method of section. Method of joint is okay. Okay, you can use method of joint for any of the question. You know that. Second thing is zero force member. Only go for these two things. Zero force members. Okay, this will be enough. Forces and equilibrium, when we are talking about guys, the most important part in forces and equilibrium is Lemmas theorem. You can see how many questions they have asked from Lemmas theorem. After Lemmas theorem, if we talk about guys, there is some special thing if you say in forces and equilibrium, there are some special types of question where they will be giving you that there is a surface over which there is pure rolling going on with this sphere, and they will be giving you some this kind of structure, and they will be saying you we are applying some force onto this. They will be asking you the value of force for which this will be just about to move. So this type of question you shall go with. Nowadays there are chances that you will be getting this kind of questions. Okay, it is also on Lemmas theorem only, but I wanted to show you this because nowadays they are changing the level, so there are certain chances you may get this kind of question because it is a wonderful type in gate. Okay, they may ask this type. Next guys, when I am coming to friction, this time many new parts are added to friction, so you will be having a question for sure shot. Here you need to cover the pulley systems also because this time you may get question from pulley system, and it is newly added topic. In friction they are also asking some of the questions like whenever we are having this kind of block and they are applying some forces there, and they are just asking the height of the force so that this will be just about to topple. These kind of questions nowadays they are asking. Okay, so you need to prepare for this. Already they have asked, previous years are covering these things. Then we are coming to kinematics and kinetics. Here rotation is quite important, impact, rotation, these kind of things definitely very important. This is not a subject where I can bound you guys because this is a wonderful big subject if you go in detail. But many students are not good in mechanics. For them I will advise just go for truss, friction. These two topics are enough because truss plus friction. You will be getting, if two questions are coming, I can guarantee you one will be out of these two. Surely, even there are chances that both of the questions will be from this. Virtual work you can leave. Accept only one statement, that minimum potential energy state, all the derivatives are zero. That question I have already been asked once. So that you need to remember. Otherwise, this chapter you can leave properly. It is not going to help you in GATE. Okay. Yes, guys.
So Rupesh, sir, weightage of Somdear 6 to 8 marks. What about ME, sir? Grade up. Dear, ME is going on well. ME is going on already. Engineering mechanics. Yes, dear, I know that is headache for many of the students. Sir, I never saw the topics which you are explaining here in my textbooks. Okay, Shreyas, don't worry. I will be giving you email ID when you will be contacting. I will be sharing these notes and all. Do they ask to calculate area, moment or centroid of given area? Dear, till now they have not asked. In mechanical paper they are not asking. In civil engineering they have asked once or twice. In mechanical engineering they have never asked. In civil they have asked once or twice. But in civil weightage is only 1 mark for engineering mechanics. Okay. So this is over. Now machine design. Static, combined and fatigue loading. Here you need to go for SN diagram. SN diagram. Miner's rule. SN diagram, Miner's rule. SN diagram, Miner's rule. These you need to do, guys. And whenever we are going to discuss this SN diagram, Miner's rule, fatigue loading, it is very important. And many times questions, many times, yeah, every year question is coming from this topic. Okay. So these two are the very, very important topics, Miner's rule and SN diagram. And along with that, you need to go for Soderberg, Goodman criteria. You know, chapter is quite big. I am giving you some specific topic. Theory of failure, guys, questions are asked from MSST, MPST, and MDET. These three theories are asked. Brakes and clutches, guys, here in brakes you study many types of brakes, but the questions are coming only in simple shoe brake. And in band brake also from simple band brake. They have never asked differential. So generally simple brakes are coming. When we are talking about clutches, guys, go for UPT, UWT only. Otherwise clutches have many types. Even when I teach you, I have given you the expressions for slip also, energy loss also. But these things are not asked in paper. Never asked. So UPT, UWT, and when you are going for springs, guys, in springs you need to go for connection of springs. The expressions for strain energy, stiffness and deflection. Only this thing is required. Okay, guys. So these are the machine design topics. So design is about to complete. Next will be bearings. Guys, in bearings, when we are talking about the sliding contact bearings, Sommerfeld number and bearing characteristic number. Sommerfeld number and bearing characteristic number. Bearing characteristics number. Then when we talk about the rolling contact bearing, guys, in rolling contact bearing, load life equation is important. Also go with one more thing, that is cubic mean load. This is a new topic, but there are fair chances that question may be asked from this topic. When we are talking about joints, dear, first type is reverted joint. Go for eccentric loading. For bolted joint, also go for eccentric loading. If we talk about welded joint, guys, here only three formulas are there, you know that. And till now only two questions have been asked. So it is the least important part. If you want to leave, you can leave it. In bolted, add one thing, elastic analysis. Elastic analysis is an emerging topic in this chapter where the questions are being asked. So these are the important topics, guys, I am telling you. Okay. So any other doubt, guys? Let us move. So guys, this is something machine design, important topics. Then we are having production, guys. This is the most important subject, you know. The weightage is 15 to 17 marks. This is the most important topic of mechanical engineering. And guys, when we are talking about production, questions are sure short. There are sure short topics from which question will come. Like in welding, go for VI characteristic equation. VI characteristic equation. VI characteristic equation.
Then second questions which is coming is types of heat transfer and efficiencies. Types of heat transfer and efficiencies. Add duty cycle into that. Questions have never been asked. So there are chances that duty cycle will be included this time. Only go for numerical in welding. 2 marks numerical will be coming every year. When it comes to casting, guys, go for gating system and riser design. Those who have studied, they know they are very big topics. I am giving very much small chosen topic, 20 to 25% only. Gating system design and riser design. As well as go for non-conventional casting. Go for non-conventional casting. Okay, guys. Next is metal forming. In bulk metal forming, the most important part is rolling. Guys, 80% time questions is asked from this topic majorly if you see the recent years. But yes, extrusion, forging, wire drawing, they are also asked, like extrusion till date 3 questions are there, forging till date 2 questions are there, wire drawing 10 to 12 questions are there. So guys, as I am telling you important topics, that's why I am saying rolling. Otherwise, I will not say that leave everything. If you are planning to complete it, then that's fine. If you are planning to leave it, go for that at least. Okay. Then in metal forming, there is one more operation, that is punching and blanking. Punching and blanking. It is also a very important topic, and with that also go for deep drawing. So these are the minimum number of operations where you shall definitely go for. Okay, because majority time questions are been asked from this. I am saying these are important. This analysis is important. If you are going to leave some subject, do only these. If you are going to complete the subject, give more emphasis on them. Both the ways it is going to helpful. Metal cutting, guys, when we are talking about, first of all, I will say go for non-traditional machining method where you will be discussing ECM, EDM numerical, because they are sure they will be coming in the paper. Then guys, when we are talking about after this topic, you shall go to Taylor tool life equation. That is a must. Taylor tool life equation. These are the easiest topic from where question will come. Third is going to be the merchant circle. Merchant circle. And fourth one is economics, only 2 formulas. Just remember the formulas. Economics, only go for the formulas. Nothing more than that. Okay, guys. So these are the important topics. As I said, I will be checking the doubts, if any. Okay, guys. So these are the topics I would like to show you. Okay. So let us see the next topics. Next is metrology and inspection. Here you need to go with limits, fits and tolerance. Limits, fits and tolerance. Limits, fits and tolerance. Okay, guys. And limits, fits and tolerance is the most important topic. So here you shall definitely go for this. It is the most important topics, guys. So I am looking at the doubts also what you are asking. Yes. Yes, dear, from economics, numericals have come many times. I will definitely share the PPT, dear. Duty cycle, dear, it is in welding basically. Dear, in XE course, maths and aptitude is included. Okay, in crash course, till now it is not included because mathematics and aptitude sessions are separately already going on Grade Up app. Grade Up app as well as Grade Up YouTube channel. You can see that every day aptitude classes are going on in the night session. You can see that many sessions have already been completed. So guys, in metrology inspection, limits, fits and tolerance is the most important part. And along with that, if you want to go for taper measurement. I will give you only one topic, otherwise it is a very big subject. Taper measurement and one, you can go for tolerancing. That is enough. Tolerancing. Sim, just go for basic length unit. Go for 10 to 15 important G and M codes. एंड ज्योमेट्रिकल ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन. इन ज्योमेट्रिकल ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन गो फॉर रोटेशन. रोटेशन इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट. रोटेशन एंड रिफ्लेक्शन योर 90% क्वेश्चंस विल बी कवर्ड. ओके गाइस, दीज आर द थिंग्स आई वांटेड टू शो यू. ओके गाइस, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन ग्रेशियन दीपक. डियर, नॉट इन इंजीनियरिंग मैकेनिक्स बट यस डेफिनेटली वी विल बी गोइंग फॉर ऑन ऐप. डोंट वरी श्रेयस, व्हेन यू विल बी ज्वाइनिंग अवर सेशंस ऑन यूट्यूब आई विल बी टीचिंग यू ड्यूटी साइकिल. डोंट वरी. ऑब्वियसली अंकित, डेफिनेटली आई हैव ऑलरेडी प्लान दैट. सो नेक्स्ट इज इंडस्ट्रियल इंजीनियरिंग ब्रेक इवन एनालिसिस एंड सीक्वेंसिंग. गाइस, फ्रॉम हेयर यू नीड टू जस्ट गो फॉर, आई विल से दैट when you will be going for sequencing, go for n jobs, 1 and 2 machine problems only. They are enough for gate. And when you are going for break-even analysis, it is only a small topics where you know the formula is when you find out total sales revenue is fixed plus variable cost plus profit. For break-even analysis, you will put it 0. So it is already a small topic. So here what I shall recognize to do. Inventory control, you go for EOQ model only. The first model is the most important. Then go for internal production system. These two are asked frequently. Along with that, go for probabilistic model. Because nowadays, probabilistic models are coming every year. So they are only two models, you know. One is static inventory model. Other is service level model. Service level model. We will be covering all these things in the crash course, guys. So don't worry. In PERT CPM, go for critical path. Critical path, float, and crashing. You will be saying, sir, everything you have said in this chapter, because guys, this is the most important chapter. If I want to give you only 2 marks for industrial, I will be asking the question from this topic. LPP, guys, go for graphical method. That is the most important. Graphical method and special cases of all other topics. Like simplex method, only special cases are important. Okay, they will be asking question from specific parts only. PPC, guys, is a theoretical, very big part. It is better to leave if you are going for partial preparation. If you are going for complete preparation, you shall prepare it completely. Otherwise, there is no need to go for that because it is having many theory parts. Still, if you want to go for 2 things only. One is product life cycle. Other is, guys, whenever we are going to do this chapter, there is some leveling is done in the inventory system, like one product required 2 other byproducts. Okay, like if you want to make 1x, you need to have A and B, like 2 A and 3 B are required. Then for making A, you need 1 Y and 2 Z. So this type of question are asked in PPC. Okay, this is known as basically when we are talking about here, you need to find out if I want to make 1000 quantity of X, how many quantities of B will be required. So such kind of questions are coming. Okay, so those kind of questions you need to cover. Many times they have been asked, you can see in previous years. Okay, so these are the thing I wanted to tell you. Dear, I will be coming on fluid mechanics also. Don't worry about that. I will be coming on fluid mechanics also. Let us see, some other doubts are coming, guys. Actually, it is showing slightly with slight delay. So don't mind, guys. We are about to complete it now. Don't worry. Okay, guys. Let's move further. Shreyas, in final, please give a rough weightage of all subjects so we will get a clarity again. Please explain us difference between ME and XE. If XE is that good means I did go apps. Dear, XE is an additional. Dear, simplex is not very important. Simplex is not important. Special cases of simplex are important. I would like to say, dear, I am coming on to Shubham, FM and HT. Shreyas, I would like to say you, XE is good as an extra paper, not good as a main paper. It is good as an extra paper because when you are preparing for XC, subjects are from mechanical only. Okay, but it is not good as an individual. So whenever the applications GoApps again will be open, you fill it as an extra form because two papers are allowed now. You can fill XC. So as an extra paper, it is good. As a main paper, it is not good. Okay. Next, let us see, guys. From forecasting exponential smoothing, as I am giving you only important topic, mind it. Exponential smoothing. 80% time questions are coming from this only. Exponential smoothing. Queuing theory, you know there are 6 formulas only. Still from them, the most important formula is related to Little's rule. There are 10 formulas actually, but Gate have asked only 6 formulas till date. So Little's rule is the more important thing out of this. Line balancing, never the question have been asked. Only once it came. So you can leave this part. Okay guys. Yes. Then basic thermodynamics. In zeroth law, questions will be coming from thermometry. Question will be coming from thermometry. Only that is important, but not very important in thermodynamics. When we go for heat and work, in heat and work, you need to remember all the expressions for heat and work. It is required from here, questions are generally asked. When we are coming to first law of thermodynamics, here you need to go for steady flow, open system approach. Okay, so there the questions are asked many times. They mention there is a turbine, there is a compressor. By looking at turbine compressor, we feel that the question is from application, but it is from basic thermodynamics. First law is applicable, so you need to just apply first law and conserve the energy from inlet and outlet, and you get the required unknown. This type of questions are asked many times, guys. Then in second law of thermodynamics, questions will be coming from heat engine and refrigerator combinations. So it is a very required one. You have seen they apply one heat engine, one refrigerator. They say net of this much work done is coming. Then they ask you what is the source temperature, what is the sixth sink temperature, what is Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. This type of questions are coming in second law. In entropy, you need to remember only the 5 formulas. You know that for gate paper. Otherwise, for interviews, you need to know this in a very, very great depth. 5 formulas, like you know, there are some processes. Like what is the change of entropy? There are 3 formulas, like whenever you go for ideal gases. Okay, those formulas you need to study. There is time is less, otherwise I would have written those formulas. Okay, there are some formulas related to, like when throttling is going on, free expansion is going on, mixture of gases. So in these kind of things, whenever you go for the formulas, those formulas you need to remember, they will be asked from you. Next is availability and irreversibility. Here you need to remember the formulas for irreversibility kind of things. Okay guys, so hope you are getting the things. Yes dear, we are having a class at 9:30. I am about to leave this session, don't worry. Yes dear, they ask open system, but not unsteady. They do not ask. Unsteady is asked in engineering services. In gate, they ask steady flow. Okay, they do not ask unsteady flow. Okay guys, so now as the time is less, so I am just giving you some, I will be sharing this PPT to the app people on the app. So guys, just download the GradeUp app. There you will be getting this PPT with all the topics. I will be giving that in the PDF format in more elaborative way, so that you can have that list always with you. So don't worry, just download the app and follow me there. So guys, pure substantial and thermodynamic relationship. Here Maxwell's relations are important. Here Maxwell's relations are important. Along with these Maxwell's relations, there are some other things also you need to study. That is, you know, Joule-Thomson coefficient. Joule-Thomson coefficient. Joule-Thomson's coefficient. That is also important. Okay guys. So these are the important things you need to cover here. So guys, I have discussed nearly all the subject. Only 2 subjects are pending, that is fluid mechanics and HMT. So Tuesday I am going to start strength of material. You already know that crash course will be started on Tuesday. So on Tuesday only I will be discussing those pending subjects, as the time is less, and also thermal application part. Okay, so as time is less, because already we are taking a session from 8 p.m. So guys, let us close this session here, and thanks for joining me. And on Tuesday we are starting crash course. Just join me there for strength of material. We will be having important topic discussion as well as their questions. And you will be learning a lot more in all the subjects. That is my promise to you. And by this crash course, we are at least improving, at least going to improve your 15 to 20 marks. If you are at 50, we will make you reach at 65 to 70. If you are at 30, we will make you reach up to 50. Okay. So just leave your queries, whatever the tensions on us. You just study, follow us, join us on app, YouTube. You will be learning a lot more. This is my promise to you. Guys, just see the free lectures available on app as well as YouTube. You will be knowing the level we are providing here. Okay, guys. So, goodbye for this session. I am looking at the question. If any, I will be answering it. And then we are closing the session right now. But on Tuesday, I will be going for the pending subject. One more important announcement. On Sunday, Engineering Services Conventional paper is there. So after 8 p.m. we will be giving you a weightage analysis of ESC conventional on the same day. So it will be good if you join us. If you are thinking of preparing for ESC for next year, it will be helpful for you guys. Goodbye guys for this session. Thanks for joining and thanks for having a great faith. Okay, goodbye guys. Yes, I am giving the email ID. Okay, you can... Even you can tag me over app also. Even you can ask me anything on GradeUp app. I am also available on GradeUp app. You can ask me anything there. Okay, there also I will be answering you. Don't worry. Okay, good night guys. And thanks for joining. Thanks for joining guys. Thanks Varun, we will be meeting soon there.